These tough fights that nobody wants to take, the Ruslan fight. Now that Diego Chavez, he even thinks this is very comparable to that. How do you feel about him taking on these, you know, really tough assignments?
You know what? It's sad to say, but you know, coming back to the same thing. Bradley's he's not at the stage where he has the privilege to choose who he can fight, who can't he fight. Mm-hmm. Early before we started camp negotiations, he was in line to fight Cotto. Excuse me. There was a lot of talks for Bradley and Cotto, December 6th. And then Cotto changes his mind and says, you know what, I'm not fighting this year. So then they come back and they give us names. They give us, I honestly thought we were going to fight Alvarado because that was our second option, fight Alvarado. And then all of a sudden, Alvarado has other plans. So Tim's there. So at the end of the day, it's who they want Tim to fight. Mm-hmm. It's not who Tim wants to fight. It's who they want to fight. You know, always the question is, who would you like to fight? We would like to fight a lot of people, man. But it's not who we want. It's who they want, you know? Unfortunately, you know, Tim is just unfortunate enough to not have that choice.
What do you think of Cotto Canelo? Cotto's supposed to fight Bradley. Mm-hmm. Kind of went in a different route. So what do you think of that? Who wins that fight?
Cotto Canelo? You know what? It's a evenly matched fight. You know, I just think that fight, it could go either way. Why? Because Canelo is young. Canelo's young. He's strong. You know, he suffered his first defeat to the best fighter in the world, which is Mayweather. I mean, he couldn't overcome the speed. But at the same time, Cotto has gotten a lot better, you know, in his last fights. You saw him, you know, just demolish Sergio Martinez when I honestly thought that Sergio was gonna beat him, honestly. But he just goes in there and, you know, coming like a beast and just takes over. So that makes the fight interesting. Makes a fight interesting. Experience on Cotto and youth on Canelo.
How would Tim Bradley do against Cotto if they fought?
You know, if Tim will fight against a Cotto, you know, that fight right there would have to be very smart and really box. We cannot get stubborn and get in and try to fight a Cotto that is solid, heavier, and a lot smarter in the way that he's been in there with a lot of better opposition, like Mayweather. You know, mm-hmm. To me, Mayweather's toughest fight was against Cotto.
Why did he say that?
Because he really took it to him. He had no respect for him. He took it to him from beginning to end. You know.
What about Castillo, Maidana?
Well, yeah. I'm talking about
recent years.
Recent years. I mean, back then when Floyd wasn't who he is now. I mean, obviously Castillo, but you know Castillo. I can tell you that because Mayweather was in town, Palm Springs, 2 weeks before the fight with Castillo the first time, and he didn't really train. He just went basically from no training to the fight. And then he says, I promise you guys, on the rematch, I'll play with him. And he did, you know, so.
Well, you know, you've been in with Pacquiao. I know you got to go up there, but you've been with Pacquiao. Do you, after seeing him in twice, do you still think Floyd's the best fighter in the world, or is Manny still one of the best in the world?
You know what? They're there. And at this point, if they both fight, I think it's an interesting fight because 2 years ago, I really thought Mayweather would beat Pacquiao, no problem. Mm-hmm. But now that Mayweather has slowed down a lot, I saw it in his last two fights, you know, that made a big difference. That makes the fight interesting now.
There you have it, Joel Diaz. Thank you so much. No, FaceTheReport.com. I'm Melissa Back reporting.